Hey guys, I'm here on Vine Street in Harrisburg, and it's time for another story time with Matt. Now today's story time is about this building right here that used to be the Daily Register office. And I wanted to kind of talk a little bit about it today because it was on my mind for some reason when I woke up this morning. So I used to deliver papers when I was a kid, and it was a pretty cool job for a kid to have. Got to ride my bike around, I got to deliver papers, and that's gone. And I was thinking about, you know, the internet and how great it is, but one of the worst things about the internet is how it's kind of just killed a lot of things that, you know, used to be so important to cities and towns like Harrisburg. When I was in high school, I worked on my school newspaper, and we went to the Daily Register office. They helped us get our papers printed. And I remember, you know, there's like 8 people working in the front room. There's 2 secretaries. There's a business, like advertising person. There's copywriters working in the front room. It's just really, really busy. A lot of action. You go into the back room, there was like 6 or 7 different reporters working. There was a layup person who was like actually cutting paper and sticking it and getting it all put together on pages. They're working on computers. This would have been 1997, but they're still kind of actually, they were still laying up the paper manually, cutting the articles out and putting them onto a piece of paper. And they were still printing them right over there in that building. So that was 1997. Well, I started writing a blog called Barn Door Cycling. And I didn't really think a lot about the newspaper. I never bought it. I never ordered the paper when I, you know, lived here. But it seemed like it was still in good shape. I really didn't think much about it. A friend of mine, Brian DeNeal, was the editor. So you know, I knew he was the editor. I would stop if I ever saw it in a store, seen it in somebody's house or whatever, I'd pick it up and read it. So, you know, I knew that we still had a paper. I didn't know much about it. So my blog, I got a letter from Gatehouse Media. I got an email. They wanted to use my blog in the newspaper, which I thought was really cool. So I was like, oh yeah, sure. You guys can use my blog in a newspaper. And, that should have been a giveaway right there. If they wanted to use my blog in the newspapers, then, you know, there's something wrong maybe. But anyway, so, because it wasn't that good of a blog. But part of getting my blog into their website, into their newspapers, was me coming here to this building to sign some papers. And this was probably, I started my blog in 2009. And I would say this was around 2013, probably. And so maybe 2014, somewhere in there. But anyway, I remember coming to this office and I had to make arrangements to meet Brian, the editor here, which stunned me because the office just wasn't open anymore. You know, I didn't know that. And so you'd go in and It was as if there had been like an evacuation of the building and everything was just left and everybody left the building, fire alarm, and didn't come back. I mean, it really didn't look that different than it had looked when I went in 1997, except for all the lights were off and everything was just left laying around. There was technology left laying around, just all kinds of stuff just left everywhere. And Brian was the only employee. I think he said he had one part-time reporter who he was having a hard time getting to do anything or getting to work or something. It was as if, I didn't realize this, the paper was dead. I mean, it was dead then. This building was dead. The printing office had closed a long time ago because they moved printing somewhere else. Circulation was down, way, way down. And eventually, they closed this building and they moved the paper now. I don't think anybody here in town actually does anything with it. We still have a city paper, but there's like, it's like 4 pages or something. And I think it's all made by robots. I don't know. maybe every now and again there's an article written by somebody who actually has been to Harrisburg. I'm not sure. But anyway, just kind of sad. Well, this has been another story time with Matt.